right. Yeah, that'll be fine.
Just let me track those contracts down. I'll get back to you.
Okay, good.
Mrs. Bauer to see you.
Oh, good. Hi. Thank you, Karen. Make sure you hold all my calls, please. Hi.
Hi, who is that?
Oh, that's Karen Kennedy. She's new. Evie left.
Why?
Oh, Evie was talking to some executives here, and they persuaded her that she was selling herself short, so she's decided to enroll in the executive training program here.
Oh, that's good for her.
Good for her, terrible for me. I wish I could get my hands on the person who persuaded her. Actually, I think I know who it is.
Anyway, good to see you. What are you doing here?
Oh, it's nothing I can't handle, so I'll just get out of your hair.
No, no, wait a second, Maureen. What is it?
It's just the school field trip committee.
Oh, I forgot. Oh,
don't worry about it. I can really handle it all.
No, wait. I want it.
Hang on just a minute. Oh, you again.
Yeah. Okay, yeah. Bring it right in. Thanks. Yes, Vanessa Chamberlain?
Yes, may I just put you on hold just for a second? Thank you very much.
I thought I told you to hold all my calls.
It must have rung when I got up to come in here.
All right, fine. Next time you leave your desk, make sure all the calls are forwarded to the switchboard. Sheila will show you how to do it.
I will. I'm sorry.
That's all right. Thank you very much.
Vanessa, why are you doing this to yourself?
Glad you could make it, Dylan.
Well, it sounded important.
It is.
Come on, have a seat. Is something wrong?
Why, something got to be wrong for me to invite you over here?
No. I've got a lot of work to do. I'm helping the hog.
Don't worry. We'll take care of it. Juan, you want to get something cold to drink?
I got some iced tea.
That's great.
Iced tea, good.
So what's up?
It's a red letter day, son.
Really?
Yeah. The first day of your future.
So Celia Walden got through post-op quite nicely. It's time to update her therapy schedule, though.
Right.
So you got something outlined for her? Daniel?
Yes?
Do you have something in mind for Ms. Walden's therapy schedule?
I saw on her chart.
Well, we couldn't find it.
Oh, it's gotta be in my office. I'll get it.
Listen, never mind. She's gonna be here in 5 minutes. You can work on it yourself.
Oh, good.
Where are you today?
Right here.
Is everything all right with Holly at the station?
Yeah, everything's fine. My life is really great right now, honestly. Roger's out of town. The longer he's away, the better my life is.
so good to be so welcomed. So what's been going on while I've been gone?
Not much. Everything's fine.
Our illustrious DA all right?
Yeah, he's doing well.
Back all better?
Yeah, it's getting better. He's able to work now.
Were you able to?
Roger, he hasn't been well.
Well, I figured he'd be flat on his back anyway.
Well, I did manage to make some progress anyhow. He's eternally grateful to me for all my help, and he won't hear of my leaving.
Oh, good. Any idea for how long?
As long as you need me there. So how was your trip?
It was interesting. I tracked down every lead Ms. Wetherill gave me. She'd been behaving herself recently?
Well, she still needs to be talked down now and again. At least she's picking up the phone instead of picking up a gun.
She really wanted to take a pot shot at St. John's.
She had it fully loaded with the safety off. I think she was serious.
Unbelievable. And amateurish.
Yeah, well, she insists that she was only trying to scare him.
And that she might just accidentally have gotten him. Mm-hmm. She's really off the spool, running out of pure emotion.
And you're not?
Do I seem emotional to you?
This is personal for you, isn't it?
If it is, I won't let it interfere with the business at hand. She's still at the hotel?
I imagine.
You imagine?
Well, if she's not, I'll track her down.
You do that. I have to get dressed.
Oh, well, I've got your dry clean here.
Good.
Tell you what. This one would be nice.
Not for today. You know, it was a very interesting trip. I was ready to write off Ms. Wetherill as a complete nutcase.
Oh, I think she could be.
But she could be right about St. John. I'm telling you, the more people I talk to, the better picture I got. He's capable of much more than we thought.
Well, how do you know? There wasn't enough evidence to prosecute him in the sister's death.
Doesn't mean he's not guilty.
Roger, do you think he's dangerous?
Let's put it this way. St. John is not the great protector that Holly thinks him to be. I'm going to make sure she finds that out.
Did you get the proposal I left on your desk?
And that was my idea for a replacement for the love bug. I mentioned it the other day.
Right. Well, honey, I've got a million things to do today. I'm sorry.
Listen, I'm sorry. Can't those other things wait?
Roger is coming back in town. I got to get some things done before he jumps all over me.
Yeah, I want to talk to Art about the dubbing equipment.
Okay, I'll hold. What happened?
I don't want to talk about that right now.
No. I've got a show. I'd like to pitch it to you. And I'm not listening to you. I'm sorry. Hold on. I'll get back to you.
Holly, I don't want your sympathy. Now, I've been working on this proposal. I think it bears hearing
out. Let's hear it.
You sure you have time?
I'm making the time.
Okay. Now, I know this has been done before, but I think that we can add enough twist to turn this into a real winner. The show is called It's a Crime. Now, Holly, imagine that someone has come into your life, someone that you've grown to trust with your heart and soul. But what you don't know is that this person is guilty of committing a serious crime.
Good. One more set.
I'd like to see you do this.
I'm sure you would.
Hi, Ed.
Hey, Sammy.
Hi.
Hi. Hi, Sam.
Hi. Boy, getting too slick for me.
I doubt it.
You're doing good work. Keep it up.
I will, Dr. Adams. Thanks.
I've got a surgery, so I'll see you day after tomorrow, okay?
Got it.
See you later, Ed.
Dr. Adams.
He's still as cute as ever. How are you and Daniel getting along? Look at him.
Something
is shouldn't. Yes, I should. Look, anybody can see it. That's the way he is with all of his patients. Can't believe I thought it was something special.
Good. Very good. We'll have one more set, and if you can handle that okay tomorrow, we'll have even more.
Well, I feel more like dancing.
I'll settle for two steps next week. I'll see you tomorrow, okay?
Okay, thank you, Doctor.
You got it.
Gift, I hope you know.
Oh, sure. Steady hand.
No, I sworn that.
Is this the way you are with your patients?
You sure you're willing to give that up for more paper pushing?
No, I have no plans to that effect.
If you were head of neurology, you'd have some patients, but you'd have to trade off time for more paperwork.
No. I'll do whatever's necessary, but I'm not going to give them up.
I'm glad to hear that.
Back me for the post?
The board is interviewing other doctors.
Like who? Who are you talking to? Tony Adams?
They're interviewing all over the country.
I understand. So just tell me whatever else I have to do to help myself out here.
They're interested in everything, so make sure that everything is in order. Make sure that everyone you have ever known has something wonderful to say about you.
A couple of months in that section, and you'll be ready for any division you want. I would like you to spend maybe a year or two in each of the major divisions, because then you'll know this company inside out, top to bottom.
And then what?
Then come and you work here with me. What would you say?
You thought a lot about this, haven't you?
Of course I have. You're my son. Hey, you know, all this is yours by birthright. Just think, three generations of Lewis's working side by side. This is right for you here.
Now, why would you say that, Billy? I told you before, I want to make my own.
I know. But I saw you the other day when I was negotiating with Whitsitt. Telling you, you had the look in your eye. HB saw it, too. You got it. You can do it.
Billy, thanks.
It's quite an awful lot, I'll give you that. But Dylan, I'm telling you, you can do it.
Do you know what you're saying? I mean, I just learned to read 2 years ago. This is insane.
Yeah, you learned to read 2 years ago, and look how you took to it. And you know why? Because you're smart. I'm telling you, boy, you can do anything you put your mind to. I know you don't want to take anything from me. You never have, and I respect that. But I don't want to see you throw away a good chance.
I don't see that I'm throwing anything away.
And that kills me. Boy, you've had it so tough for so long. It doesn't have to be the struggle that it's been.
Right, I just let you hand it to me.
No, nothing gets handed to you. You work for it. You work your tail off. But if you work, at the end of a day, at the end of year, you've got something. I'm telling you, Dylan, if you work hard, you can write your own ticket.
And just run right up the corporate ladder, right?
Yeah. What do you say?
Billy, thanks. I know this is important to you, but I don't want any part of it. I know your career is the most important thing to you, but I don't know that it is for me.
But we'll just set up a meeting with marketing and planning, and we'll just straighten the whole thing out. All right, I'm going to put you through to Karen, and let's say Tuesday for the meeting. Yeah, bye-bye.
Vanessa, I can't stand this. I'm sorry to be hanging around while you're working.
It's all right. I'm sorry I didn't have more time.
Is this really what you want?
What?
Well, I mean, you do have more in your life than a career. You have family and friends who love you.
I know I do. I'm sorry. I know I've been remiss.
No, please. It's not about me. I'm worried about you. I mean, don't you ever get out of here? Say, forget all this?
I try, actually, but, your nephew isn't making anything any easier.
Al Michael?
Yeah, he's watching me like a hawk.
Oh, Vanessa. Al Michael's ambitious, but he's really young.
Yeah, he is. I guess it's just that when you're a kid, you don't realize you are one.
And this isn't making you any younger.
Thanks.
Let's do something about it. Why don't you come out with me and Ed tonight?
No.
Why? Are you afraid you're going to feel like a third wheel?
Well, I didn't say that.
Well, you didn't have to, and you won't be.
There's a new administrator at Cedars. His name is Max something or other, and Lillian says he is very attractive.
I don't believe this.
What? What's going on, Maureen? I mean, do I really look that desperate that you feel that you have to set me up for a blind date? I mean, really,
you don't have to look at it that way.
Well, I mean, it's just going to be dinner. It's not
just going to be dinner. It's not going to be obvious that he's sitting over there and I'm sitting over here and that we're being set up.
We'll keep it very casual.
We're not going to keep it anything. We're not going to do it.
Okay. Why don't you just come out for dinner with Ed and me?
Very sweet of you, it really is. I just can't do it because I'm going to be in the office tonight till 9 or 10. Really?
No, you're not. Daniel's a very ambitious man. He doesn't let anything or anybody stand in his way. And Holly is soon going to find that out.
With a little help from you, no doubt.
I try.
You know that TV show that you had me set up with Julie Grant?
Mm-hmm.
You're going to use that to expose Daniel,
mm-hmm.
aren't you?
Yeah. Well, actually, Holly's going to do all the work. She'll do all the research herself. She'll uncover all the facts. I won't have to do a thing. Just point her in the right direction. Get her to take a good, hard look.
She might not believe it.
She will. Holly's got her problems, but she's a realist. She'll see Lover Boy for what he really is.
And then he'll be gone.
Mm-hmm. That's right.
And then what?
Well, then Holly will be on her own. And I'll have WSBR all to myself.
Well, she'll be on her own, but she won't be gone. She'll still be at the station.
Exactly.
Oh, good job. Have the end of the dance at 4:30. Pick Wendy up, come home, make her dinner, study until 9:30 or so, and then I go to bed.
Boy, that's quite a change for you.
Well, not really, except now I'm in bed asleep.
Oh, that was implying.
Okay.
Oh, it's okay, Harley.
Listen, I did what I did.
Yeah.
And now I get to do something different.
It's a trip.
I mean, have you ever tried to be in bed by 10 so you could be up at 6?
Well, for a while, I had a job where I was working with these kids, and, you know,
yeah. And now I'm happy to see it. It used to be such a drag when Wendy would get up early. I mean, I always loved her, but I hated the morning.
Now, we play together after breakfast.
That's so strange. How is your job search going?
Slow. I have a record to mail, not too many useful skills. Taking extension courses, learning to type, and maybe even learn to use the computer.
Hey, I can help you out with that if you need it.
You know how to use a computer?
Well, I had a part-time job working with computers.
Girl, you have gotten around. How many jobs have you had?
Oh, too many. Too many.
But now you've settled on one.
Yeah, I guess so.
No, I know so. I will make this work. I will not have another change in my life. Harley, look. I know we didn't have much after junior high, and so I'm not trying to act like, you know, we're best friends or anything, but you need to talk to somebody.
Me? Oh, no, I'm fine, really.
Save that for your mama.
I can't, because she doesn't believe it either.
What has happened to you in the last couple of years?
Well, I fell in love with this guy. His name was Josh. We were going to get married.
So just start collecting letters from people. Mm-hmm. Recommendation from Justin would be good. Mm-hmm. People you work with in Boston.
Well, wouldn't local recommendations make more sense?
Yeah, local would be fine too. Dr. Healy, the mayor, the DA, whatever.
The DA. Ross used to go out with Holly.
Well, I used to be married to Holly, but that doesn't mean I can't recommend you as a good doctor, and Ross can recommend you for the work you did on Sam. I mean, come on, man. He's a DA. He's got clout now. Seriously, it couldn't hurt.
Nah, you're right. It couldn't hurt.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Hey, Sam, I wish you didn't feel this way. It's his problem, you know?
No, I was a fool all by myself.
It isn't you. Maybe Daniel can only be this way with patients. People who need him. So you made the mistake of getting better. You really want to move backwards?
No.
Carrie, thanks, but it really is a lot more than that. I blew it with Daniel. I made a big mistake and I scared him off.
You're not a scary person.
No, to him I am. He thinks that I'm some kind of fatal attraction lunatic.
Come on. You're the most level-headed person I know.
Well, not this time. This time, I think I did go too far. I wanted to help, but I...
Help what?
Well, Daniel told me something once, something very private. At the time, I thought that he was reaching out to me, but I was dead wrong, and now I get the distinct feeling that he wishes he could take it all back.
So leave it alone.
I am.
Then why are we still talking about it?
I don't know. It's stupid. He's seeing this woman that I can't possibly compete with, and he's been so cold to me.
Samantha, how's it going?
Now, we'll feature a different crime every week, but only one per episode because we want to be sure and give it plenty of time. After the episode airs, we'll flash a hotline limber so that the audience can call in with any leads so we can solve the case and catch the criminals. What do you think?
I think it's nice, and I think you're right. It's been done before.
Yes, but with great success. And the other shows haven't suffered because of the others being around. I mean, people can't get enough of this. Look, Holly, there is nothing new under the sun. But the trick is to make our show intellectually and visually appealing.
You're just gonna have to find a hook to make our show different from everybody else's.
And I have. Now, we will not only go through the DA and police files, we will appeal to the audience themselves. If they've got a story and it checks out, they'll have a place to take it. We'll get them more involved.
Well, that gives us a different angle.
It's good PR, it's public service, it's entertainment, all rolled up in one.
Can't beat that. Where'd you get this idea?
Well, I developed it, but the original idea came from Ross's assistant in the DA's office, Suzanne.
Oh, yes. Suzanne.
And I think that she is even willing to give us free legal research.
Well, that'll keep the cost down.
Well, what do you think?
I like it.
Great! Great!
I should get ready to pitch it to Roger. You should probably do that on your own.
Okay. But listen, if you want to be there...
No, it might be better if I'm not even in the building.
If he thinks it's my idea, he'll shoot it down, just on principle.
You can be sure he will hate anything I ever come up with.
How do you know until you try?
No idea to Holly.
Oh.
Well. Let's hear it.
Okay. What if you found out that someone near and dear to you wasn't who you thought they were?
Story of my life.
No. I mean that you found out that they were guilty of committing a serious crime. The show is called It's a Crime. Now, each week we want to highlight an unsolved crime.
Or an unsolved police crime.
Or an unsolved police case. We'll present the facts and any existing questions.
And also any information that we uncover through investigative research. This is to give the audience the idea that they are involved in an ongoing case.
Right. And after the show, we will flash a hotline number so that they can call in their leads.
And also appeal to them for their unsolved cases.
This is where we have to keep an eye on the cost, you know, maybe that's right.
Yes, but I think that we can get free research from a connection in the DA's office.
So, PR, publicity, and entertainment. What do you think? I knew it.
You can't do this.
Do what?
I can tell you don't like it, and I do. What are we going to do? We disagree on everything we'll ever show on the air.
Why do you do this?
What?
Always assume the worst. It is so unattractive. Does Dr. St. John have to put up with this?
He's on my mind a lot lately.
Would you excuse me?
Yeah.
I feel like I should apologize. I've been really hard on you, and I'm sorry.
Are you still getting those phone calls?
Well, I've been under a lot of pressure lately with the foundation pulling funding for my project and trying to raise money for WSPR. The whole episode has kind of turned me into a Mr. Hyde. Anyway, I haven't been very fair with you.
It's okay.
I'm not so sure that I would be as forgiving if I were in your position, but I'll take it. I'd like us to be friends again. I miss you. I hate to look back on this and feel like I blew the whole thing over a stupid misunderstanding.
Don't worry, Daniel. I still consider you a friend.
Good. I have rounds, but we'll talk again soon, right?
Right.
Okay.
What was that all about?
I don't know. All of a sudden, he wants to be my friend.
Maybe he realizes what a jerk he's been. Then again, maybe he's just being weird. Doctors are so funny about their patients. They try to keep their distance, then end up getting close to you, then pull back. Who knows?
I don't know. This was something else.
What?
I don't know. When Daniel was my doctor, getting close, pushing me to get better, I believed every word he said, and these last few months, when he's been mad as hell, I believed that too, but this...
What are you saying?
I'm not sure that I believe how he was just now.
Thank you. Now, what is this, Daddy?
You cannot work until 10, and that is final.
Oh, are you grounding me?
Yes. There's something important you have to do tonight.
Yes, there is. I have to keep my job.
Well, this is important to your job. The Business Association's Man of the Year banquet.
Oh, well, that I can certainly miss.
Oh, darling, you can't miss it.
Why not?
Well, because you have to represent Spaulding.
No, I don't, Daddy. We're going to have a lot of people there. No important business ever gets done, and I won't even be missed.
Darling, you might enjoy it.
He's right. Why not go?
Have you ever been to one of those dinners? Once or twice? And you're standing there and telling me that I ought to go?
Well, it's not that bad.
Oh, really? I mean, I get so sick and tired at those dinners of hearing people talk about their portfolios and their market value, I could just scream.
You don't have to talk to anybody. Just be there.
Why?
Darling, I've told you, it's the Man of the Year award tonight.
Well, Daddy, I don't care. Those dinners are an ordeal, and unless you win, there's just no point in going.
Precisely.
Vanessa, I think Henry's trying to tell you something. Go.
Look, I got the deal sitting right here in front of me. No, I just don't think that they're gonna... Wait a second. Look, well, I'm gonna call you right back, okay? What are you gonna do, walk out on me?
Well, you're busy. I know I'm busy, too, so...
Come on, Dylan, I want to talk to you about this.
Billy, I heard you. And honest, I really appreciate it, but...
But you don't want anything to do with me or with Louis Orr.
I just don't want you handing me a job because you feel sorry for me.
I don't feel sorry for you. I just want to help you.
Because you think my life is just such a big waste, right?
No, I see you building bookcases. You could be building skyscrapers, laying out all...
Sometimes a person needs a bookcase, and not a skyscraper.
Oh, come on, Dylan. If you were happy building bookcases, I don't care what it was, I'd back you. But you're not happy. I don't think you are. You want more. I can feel it.
If I want more, I'll go after it.
Will you?
Yes. I just don't want everything handed to me on a silver platter. I'll make my own achievements.
Look, if you work for me and nothing be handed to you, and you tell me about these achievements you've accomplished.
I'm making my own way. Look, I just finished that drafting course.
Yeah, good. You went to school, good. What else?
There's lots of things I'm good at, Billy.
Like when I making a good hamburger when a hawk isn't there at company?
Man, I'm out of here, okay?
Now, hold on a second, Dylan. Hold on.
Sorry to interrupt, but HB just called and he wants you to go to that Business Association award dinner tonight.
Darling, I'm not sitting through any award dinner. You just call HB back now. I can't make it.
Why do I have to give all the ugly messages? He's not gonna like it.
Darling, he knows that I can't stand it. It'll be okay. You just tell him. Look, Dylan.
It's not fear that's holding you back here, is it?
Billy, I ain't afraid of nothing.
Good. Just don't let your pride get in the way of bettering yourself.
It was right after Josh left.
But it wasn't. You know what was?
No.
I was getting dressed one morning. I went to my closet and I opened the door. And it hit me. I looked at all these blazers and these blouses and these very tasteful things. And I started to cry. These were all the things that I wore in Josh's house, in his life. In that instant, I saw how much I'd changed and how much I'd grown up. And I realized that it never would have worked. Even if Josh had stayed, it never would have worked because it just wasn't me. And I felt more lonely then than when he left because I didn't even have that dream to hold on to anymore that it would have worked. I mean, I lost him, but I lost myself too. And I ended up sleeping on the couch of some girl that I barely knew, just trying to figure out who I am. I sound like some kind of a wacko or something, don't I?
No! Everybody feels lonely and cries. I know I do.
So what did you do?
Burn him? Throw him out the window? Start a whole new life?
No, well, I mean, the clothes are me now. I didn't need new clothes. I just need a new life. And it's taken me months. Different jobs and latching on to old memories and people. Grab onto anything to make sense of it all. And that's how I ended up in the bar down on Fifth Street.
Oh, that made a lot of sense.
No, but it did. It did, because for the first time in months, I felt like myself. I mean, when Hutchins started hassling you, I knew exactly what to do. I knew exactly who I was.
So did everybody else. You were so loud.
Yeah, that's right, but that's because we have to be right. And I realized then that I have choices, many choices, but one of them is that I can be one of those people, like you and me, who's screaming out loud, just trying to get a break, or I can be somebody who's working my butt off to give them a fair deal. So here I am with, you know, my regulation handcuffs and my manual. And the world just better watch out, right?
I've got an ugly tooth for you.
You're not going to save the world. And if that's what you're trying to do, you're going to get your heart broken. I'm only trying to save a really small part of it. More importantly, I'm just trying to save myself. And I'm not living somebody else's life.
You can have anything you want, no matter what happens at the academy.
Maybe. I mean, I have certainly failed at enough jobs to know that you can start all over again. But this matters to me. This is really important to me, and I will be damned if somebody is going to stop me.
Sounds like you have someone in particular in mind.
Oh, I do. I do, and I will show you.
Dr. St. John is not the issue here. We are talking about this show. Stop playing games.
I'm just standing here.
Yeah, you're just standing here toying with us. Why don't you tell us you don't like it and get it over with?
You want me to turn it down?
Well, I can tell you're going to. It's so silly. You'll veto her idea. I'm going to veto anything you come up with. What, eventually we'll just be running test patterns on the air?
Why are you so combative? I haven't said a word.
You don't have to. It's all over your face. I like it, so it's not going to fly.
Why do you do this? You have no idea what I think.
So tell me.
Well, if you could just be still for a moment, I would.
Go ahead.
I like it.
You like it?
Yes, I like it. I think it's just what we need for the early evening time slot. I do have one suggestion. Why don't we also hire our own private investigator? That way, when people call in their leads, we can help track them down.
That's great. We'd be the place to bring you a case that you can't solve or don't have the money to take care of yourself.
Right. The poor man's dragnet.
Right.
We're going to get some nutcases.
Well, we'll just have to weed them out. You want the job? We'll put you on the phone.
Oh, no thanks. Just the same. But I do have an idea about that. What about Edie? She's not doing it. I know, see?
Jackson.
You must be there, please.
Because
somebody we know is going to win the Man of the Year award.
Oh, Daddy. Oh, come here. Oh, I'm so proud of you. Why didn't you tell me that to begin with? Now you're going to need your tux. Is it ready? You want to wear it?
Yes.
Good. I'm not sure I have anything to wear. Oh, well, it's all right. I'll find something.
Darling, it doesn't matter what you wear. Please just promise to be there.
Of course I promise. I wouldn't miss it for the world.
Come on, Jim. Hey, look, just try it. Come on, boy. I'm telling you, nobody is going to hand you anything. I just want you to take the chance.
I'm not interested.
Why? What do you got to lose? You're not going to lose. If you really try, you won't lose.
Bailey, your daddy is about ready to string you up. He wants you to go to that banquet tonight.
I can't go to the banquet. I'm taking Dylan to dinner.
No, you're not. I got things to do.
Just call Daddy back and tell him then I can't make it.
Oh, you call your own daddy. Why do I have to give all the bad messages?
Darling, that's what I pay you for.
He's going to tell you the same thing that he tells me. Go to that banquet or else.
Okay, what is so important about this banquet?
You're asking me? All I know is they serve food and they give out that Business Association Man of the Year Award.
The old dog. He wants to get me there because I won the award. That's it, isn't it?
HB didn't say that.
No, of course he wouldn't. He wants more surprise. You see, I turned my life around.
Yeah, that's good.
Why don't you try to turn your life around?
Maybe I don't think my life's such a big mess.
I didn't say it wasn't that. Hey, tell you what, come on that dinner with me tonight. I really want you to come.
Hey, you want a lot today, don't you?
Yeah, I do. Will you come?
I don't know if I can make it.
Billy, you need me to bring you anything for tonight? You got your tuxedo at home?
Yeah, I do.
Congratulations. I think we all deserve a raise.
Yeah, I bet you do. Man of the year. Yeah, like...
Work.
I think we all got excited about it.
Well, I think some of us got more excited as the pitch went on. I'm sorry Holly rode over you like that. You were doing fine on your own.
Oh, thank you. I'm just glad she liked it.
Me too. And don't worry. I know whose idea it was.
Things to do, but it won't take long. Wait for me. You want to wait in my office?
No, I'll wait in the car.
Okay.
So I see you made it back all right.
No plane crashes, sorry.
Oh, well, it's nice to see her smiling so much. I'd like to keep it that way.
Channel 6 newsroom. What happened to a Barrington family of three? Police are tracking down clues, and we'll have the details tonight on 6 News at 6.